Let's go. Time is money. I did.
In 1863, on the banks of the Missouri River, the last chapter in the monumental undertaking of the Transcontinental Railroad began. The workers of the Union Pacific Railroad began laying their tracks westward from Omaha through the wild heart of the North American continent. Massive challenges awaited them. Away from all civilization, the country was vast, the weather ruthless, and the challenges tremendously energy-sapping. But there was a masterstroke of modern engineering to be accomplished. To tame the wilderness and to conquer it with steel, fire, and steam. Never before had anything like this been ventured, but the time was ripe.
Greetings. My name is Thomas Clark Durand. Exactly, the head of Union Pacific. We will go down in history as the ones who created the Transcontinental Railroad. And that, my friend, is your job as chief engineer. I can't supervise everything here on site right now, as I have to meet with some politicians in Washington. First, you should familiarize yourself with the basic controls. Move the camera in all directions. Now test the camera's zoom function. You can also rotate the camera. Give it a try. Very good. Now you know the basic controls. Your first task is to create a rail connection between Omaha and Norfolk to the northwest. Both cities will need a station for this. You already have a station in Omaha, but you still need to build one in Norfolk. To do this, switch to building construction mode. Very good. Now the two stations need to be connected with tracks. To do this, switch to track construction mode. Now plan the tracks between the stations in Norfolk and Omaha. To do this, select the two station tracks one after the other. Then pay for your track planning. Now create your first train so that you can set up a rail line between your stations. Initially, your train only exists on paper. It's not much use to you without a locomotive. Additionally, each train needs a rail line that passes through all the stations it should stop at. Now join your two stations to the rail line by selecting them one after the other. That's enough for your first rail line. Now confirm it so it becomes active. Very good. Now you can see the journey your train will take. If there is something to transport, the train will automatically take it. However, as each locomotive needs water, sand, and lubricant on its journey, you have to place a supply tower along the route. Very good. Your train is now traveling between Omaha and Norfolk. But you can do even more. Each city needs goods from the surrounding area. For example, every city needs corn. Look, there is a corn farm near Omaha. Until now, the corn has made it to the city in the conventional way, but we want to change that. Now construct a rural train station in the marked location with a corn farm within its radius. Now connect the new rural train station to the station in Omaha. And now things are getting tricky as we have to deal with a logistical problem. As Norfolk should also enjoy fresh corn, there will soon be two trains traveling on the stretch of track between Omaha and Norfolk. Of course, this will then result in a conflict. Since trains cannot travel through each other, you'll need a sidetrack between Omaha and Norfolk. This consists of one parallel track and two signals. First, create a sidetrack. It needs to be at least long enough for a fully loaded train. Excellent. However, your trains won't necessarily use the sidetrack, as they generally always take the shortest route. For this reason, you'll also have to specify the direction of travel on each parallel track. Now open building construction mode and set up a signal in the highlighted area pointing in the direction of the switch. Trains will then be able to stop here when the single track is in use. Now make sure that the track can only be traveled in one direction. For this purpose, set the signal so that trains coming from the opposite direction cannot pass. Excellent. Now do the same on the parallel track so that each parallel track has a different direction. Place a second signal in the highlighted area and block the track to trains coming from the opposite direction. Very good. I'm sure that it wasn't at all easy. You will soon come to realize that signals are an important aid in guaranteeing smooth rail operations. You will find more information and tips under Hints and Tips. Now assemble a new train and give it a locomotive and a rail line. Your new rail line should run via Omaha to Norfolk so that the people of Norfolk can be supplied with corn. Excellent. The corn farm will automatically make use of your train because the cities along your rail line are demanding corn. Conventional transportation is much more costly for the farm. We are still missing something. Locomotives wear out over time and need to be regularly maintained so they can perform their duties more reliably. For this purpose, there needs to be at least one maintenance building on each rail line where locomotives can be serviced if necessary. Construct such a maintenance building at your station in Omaha now. To do this, select the station itself and expand the station with this building. Right, we've been lollygagging for long enough. I need to return to Washington for further miserable negotiations with our representatives of the people. I've written a task list for you. Take a look at it and complete the tasks within the given time period. Do not disappoint me. Good. That's finished. You're making progress.
Thank you.
Those politicians in Washington get on one's nerves. But now let's get back to your tasks. As you can see, Cheyenne is still a little town hoping for an upswing caused by the railroad connection, but a city will only attract new inhabitants if it is supplied with enough goods. Cities receive basic goods from the surrounding area. If you construct stations in the right places and establish rail lines, your trains will be used to transport goods and you will make profits for transportation. But for this, you have to know what goods a city actually needs. You can find out any city's current needs. Now select Cheyenne and view the city's demand for goods. As you can see, Cheyenne currently needs only a handful of goods, and you can only deliver goods that are in demand. As the city grows, it will demand further goods. At the moment, you can supply grain and wood. Both of these goods are available to the north of Cheyenne. Connect Cheyenne to a timber business and a wheat farm and establish a new rail line that connects them both to Cheyenne. Well done. The city will soon grow. You can see how well it is being supplied at any time in the city dialogue. Basically, a city will grow once its demands are sufficiently met. I think you have learned enough. Complete the rest of your tasks. But you certainly won't have any success with so little capital. I might have not planned on this being a loss-making business, but I'll help you out this one last time. Yes, one more thing. Your company has also a research department to help you unlock new locomotives and other innovations. Open the research dialogue to find out more about it. Here you will find the advances that can be achieved in the current era. Advances from previous eras are usually already active, but what the future holds, we do not know. For each advance, you require innovation points, which you get automatically each month, and which can be increased in various ways. Now, take a look around here, and then unlock an innovation of your choosing. How about a new locomotive? My opponents say I'm lining my own pockets. These are, of course, hideous lies. And look at it this way. With the profits I'm making, I can invest much more. Jobs, jobs, jobs. Thank you. I have to wrangle with a lot of competitors, but if one person really gets on my nerves, then it's that Beatrix von Pomp. What? You haven't encountered her yet? Be glad. She takes everyone to the cleaners. Excellent. Cheyenne is becoming a major railroad hub, and the credit is all ours.
Thank you.
Do you know that many people call the vast stretch of land between the Mississippi and California the Great American Desert? Those fools. Once my railroad has opened everything up, the value of these lands will go through the roof.
Thank you.
Cheyenne will flourish thanks to you. And for each mile of track that we lay, we receive 10 square miles of land. The politicians have no idea of the value of the assets they're giving away, but that stays between us. Well done. The citizens of Denver are impressed by the railroad. Now you've managed to cross the Great Plains. A masterpiece.
Thank you.
Progress is enormous. The Far West is no longer so.
In spite of all the challenges, the Union Pacific Railroad managed to cross the endless expanses of the Great Plains and conquer the merciless slopes of the Rocky Mountains. The Central Pacific Railroad approached from the west. But the winter of 1868 brought all work to a standstill. The two lines lay just a few hundred miles across from each other, in the middle of nowhere in the mountains. The dream of the first transcontinental railroad seemed to be within touching distance, but was buried by house-high masses of snow and blown away by icy snowstorms, a dream that had begun almost four decades before.